And the host for today is Ms. Manbir Kaur. So over to you, Manbir.
Thank you, Spandana. I welcome all my guests to the today's flight to the Iceland. So talking about the location of this place, so you all can see a red mark over here in world map. So it is a place which is Iceland. So this country is located in the North Atlantic Ocean, as you can see. So it geologically lies between North America and the European island. Now moving forward, so Iceland is a Nordic island nation, which is defined by its dramatic landscapes with volcanoes, geysers, hot springs, and lava fields. So there are massive glaciers which are protected, and this place have a lot of national parks as well. So the most of the people or the most of the population lives in the capital city of this country, which we will discover in further slides. Okay, so here you can see the map of the country Iceland. So this country is basically divided into different 8 regions. So like usually different countries are like divided into states. So this country, it is divided into different regions. So it is divided into different 8 regions. Okay, so everybody know Iceland. So it is actually basically comprised of red, blue, and white. Blue here identifies
the Manbir, your voice is breaking.
Does anyone want to say something?
Yes, Manbir, your voice is breaking a little bit.
Okay, so
It's still breaking, Manbir. You can rejoin, I think. No, Manbir, it's still breaking.
So there could be.
Okay, so till then, who has written some facts about Iceland?
Ma'am, me, Rohita.
Ma'am, I.
Okay, first let's start with Rohita and then we'll go one by one, okay? Rohita, tell your facts.
Ma'am, when I checked the population of Iceland in net, it showed only 3.60 lakhs.
Mm-hmm.
I was shocked about that, so I don't know if it's correct or wrong.
It might be, it depends on the place, how much land area they have also, no? So it depends on that.
Okay, the other ones, one of the oldest democracies, it's one of the oldest democracies in the world.
Uh-huh.
It's the safest country in the world.
Oh, that's great.
1 minute, ma'am. And then Iceland is being called the land of fire and ice.
Oh, that's great.
McDonald's is banned in Iceland also.
Okay.
There are no snakes in Iceland.
Uh-huh.
The most dangerous animals in Iceland are Arctic foxes, Arctic tern, minks, etc.
Okay.
A number of tourists died in Iceland. And then turtles and dogs are banned in Iceland. Its national language is Icelandic. It has 32 letters.
All right, that's great to know, Rohita. Before moving further, Manbir, is the network all right now? Manbir?
Yes, I'm just sharing my screen.
All right. So Anush and Arhan, we can speak about your facts a little by later. First, let Manbir continue with her presentation.
I don't have facts.
Huh? Yes, Arhan?
I don't have facts.
All right. So Anush, share your facts a little by later, all right? So first we will finish this. Okay. Manbir, over to you. You can put it on slideshow, Manbir. It's still not. Okay. Now it is. All right. We can't hear you, Manbir. Manbir, still your voice is breaking a little bit.
Yeah, it's breaking a lot.
Yes, it's because of some rain. There is too much rain over there.
But I don't have any rain over here.
Yeah, but Miss Manbir is in a place where there is a lot of rain right now. So she's facing a little network issues. So she will join once again. Before that, Anush, you can share your facts.
Yes, ma'am. The Iceland is also known for its volcanoes. Volcanoes, after each 7 or 3 months, one volcano blasted and it flows very, very little bit lava, but it's danger to go near the volcano. And at the Iceland, the baby, the families sleep baby at the angan mein sulate hai, ma'am, wo apne babies ko.
Oh, okay. Abir, that's all, Anush, you have shared? You have written?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, that's great to know, Anush. Abir, yes, you raised your hand.
Although very rare, you can only see killer whales, orcas, in the western part of Iceland. In fact, one killer whale that is at SeaWorld Orlando was caught in Iceland.
Oh, that's great to know. Who else raised hand? Anush. Yes, Anush.
Ma'am, and the Iceland is second happiest country in the world. Because 100% of the public has well educated and all the have very well jobs.
That's great. That's good to know that the country is so developed and happy also. There is a happiness meter which one of the platform collect all the data from. They have different criteria from which they collect all this data and say which country is the happiest, how people are happy in all those criteria, okay? So that's how they collect that. So as this Ms. Manbir has told, Iceland is 103,000 square kilometer. It's about one quarter larger than Ireland, or about the size of the state of Ohio. It's in America, so it's almost about the state of Ohio. So you can imagine why they have a so little population also, as Rohita told us earlier. So the next slide is, okay, some history about Iceland. It was founded more than 1,000 years ago during Viking age. So the people over there lived who they were called.
What is Viking?
Yeah, people who lived over there were called as Vikings. They were known for their warriors. They were known for their big shapes and for their strength and all. They were very famous for that. And they were settled over there, mixed with Norse and Celtic population. They were also the people over there, like Norse people and Celtic people. They were called like that. Like for India, we call ancient Indians who lived over here or like that, right? Or some other dynasties we can call Mughals. You remember that? Mughals who ruled over here and Cholas and all those things like that. They had Vikings, Norse and Celtic people. And Iceland remained part of Denmark, but in keeping with the rise of nationalism around Europe in the 19th century, an independence movement was emerged. So before the independence, they remained as a part of Denmark, and then the independence happened. So the capital of Iceland is Reykjavik, and the capital, and it is also the largest city of. Yes, Arhan.
Which you had given the task, I written Reykjavik also.
Yes. Do you have any other facts regarding that capital city?
It is the largest city.
Yes, it is. Correct. Yes, Abir. Abir, you raised your hand.
Now I see that many countries have the capital city also as its largest city.
It's usually like that, but not particularly in India, because India is too big, right? So these countries are a little bit smaller. So I think it's largest because it's also most populous. There are many industries and all those happening, right? So it might be the largest and populous city also. Maybe that is the reason. Okay. So the next one, Rohita has told us that it only had 3 million approximately people in 2021 based on Worldometer elaboration of latest United Nations data. It is UN data according to 2021.
So the population was how much? 300 and something?
Yeah, 3 million.
3 million?
Sorry, 3 lakhs.
3 lakhs?
Yeah. How much does India have?
Something in billions or something.
1.3 billion.
1.3 billion, yeah.
That is too high than the lakh which they have, right? Okay, so the official language of Iceland is Icelandic, which is spoken by at least 300,000 of the other people who live there. And Iceland has 100% literacy rate, as Ansh has told us. They have a very good education rate, literacy rate. And according to the semi-official source, about 97% of Icelanders speak Icelandic as their mother tongue. So almost 97% of the people in Iceland speak Icelandic. So it's the majority spoken language. So how is the Iceland governed? So what is the government of Iceland? It's a constitutional republic with a multi-party system. As Rohita told, it's one of the oldest democracy country. And the head of a state is the president. And executive power is exercised by the government. It means the power holds by the is held by the government. And it's also the world's oldest parliamentary democracy, with the parliament called as Althingi, was established in 930. BC, I think, and legislative power is vested in both parliament and the president. So the power to govern is with both the parliament and the president, just like we have in almost all democratic country. So this is the president. His name is really lengthy. It's Guðni Thorlacius Johnson. He is the president of Iceland right now. And the prime minister is Katrín Jakobsdóttir. And the currency is Icelandic krona. So what is the currency of Hungary? Do you remember that? You went there today.
Hungarian?
No.
That was a language, yeah.
That is a language.
Florilson.
Sorry?
Florist.
Florint. Florint. Correct. Correct. Uh-huh. It's Florint. Yes, yes. So, Icelandic krona. So, one Icelandic krona is equal to 0.60 Indian rupee.
What?
Yes. So, it has a national sport. Its team handball is often referred to as national sport, and Iceland's team is one of the top ranked teams in the world.
In what is the top ranked?
It's top ranked, one of the top ranked. It's not given which rank right now because it changes every year and every time they play, right? So winning the silver medal at 2008 Summer Olympics in Beijing, China, and a bronze medal in 2010 European Championship. So it's called as handball. Have you played handball before? I don't think many of us do know about handball, right?
Many people in my apartment play it.
Oh, that's great. That's great. So this is a national sport. Okay. So the next slide is climate. We'll see what is the climate of the Iceland. So in Iceland, the climate is cold. Obviously. Yes, it is cold, windy, and cloudy for most of the year. And of course, it's a cold country because of the high latitude, and it can receive cold winds from North Pole. So from the North Pole region, they get all these cold winds. That's why it's mostly cloudy and windy. But it's also tempered by the ocean. They have too much coastal area also. So that maintains, balances them.
Just like all places they have that have ice, there will be some cold, frigid water with them.
Yes, correct. Yes. So we'll look at the beautiful places of this country. So the Blue Lagoon in Grindavik, it's an entire Blue Lagoon industry has grown around this attraction since it first became a hit. So now there is a whole industry around this lagoon, which is over there. So lagoon is like a water separated from large water. Like it's a small water body, which is separated from the big water body, like some ocean or something. It's separated and has some formed its naturally separated. So like a small island region and all those things. Okay. So now it's become an industry where people go there for tourism and also to enjoy themselves. And water from underground hot springs reaches 37 to 39 degrees Celsius, and it is said to be highly beneficial for both health and skin. So there is steam around here, right? So it's because of the hot springs. It gives out nice temperature, which is good for the health and skin. So the next one is spectacular geysers. Have you seen a geyser before?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Huh?
No, not that kind of geyser, right?
Yeah, I mean everybody does have a geyser in their bathroom, but
that is different, obviously.
Yeah, but this is a different.
So it's a rare phenomenon, actually. It's because of some natural condition. Earth is a very special place, right? There are many natural phenomena happening around the world, and this is one of them. And water is ejected like from the ground. It also accompanies with the steam with them. So this is one of the most popular fountain geyser in the country. And it is thoroughly famous around the world. And this is highly active hot spring area. And it is a favorite stop along what's known as Golden Circle. Near it, there is a place called that. And boiling mud pits of around 100 other smaller exploding geysers are waiting to be explored here. So there are many other geysers also, smaller ones. So, but this is the most famous one. So it shoots water for like 30 meters into the air. That's too high. See how people look smaller in front of the geyser over there.
That's too high.
Yeah.
More than a giant.
Yes. So the Northern Lights. Yes, this is one of the most beautiful.
I need to write this down. This is
very. Write it down.
The Northern Lights.
Yes. You have heard of it before, right?
There's a song called Aurora.
Yes.
Is it in every place where there's ice? It looks like it.
It's usually seen in the North Pole, actually. Near to that place. So, near to North Pole, almost everything is like an iced place, right? So,
yeah.
Because of that, it's seen. It's also called as Polar Lights or Northern Lights. It's a natural light displayed on the Earth's sky and usually seen in an Arctic or Antarctic region. Okay?
Ma'am? I know it was in Antarctica.
Yeah.
Ma'am,
Iceland, even Antarctica.
Yes,
and I want to go to
Ma'am, Iceland's language is more than 1,000 years old.
Oh, that's great to know. That's great to know. Yes, Arhan, you were saying something?
I actually want to go to this.
Yes, even I want to watch Aurora once in my life because it looks very, very beautiful. But it might be really cold also. So if you're not a cold person, that will be difficult. I feel
warm actually. Oh. So this will be a good place for me to.
Yes, yes, correct. So this is one of the beautiful places which you can go. So if there is too many people and all, it's difficult to look at all these things. So usually in the remote areas where you can form a tent and wait over there and see these northern lights at the night time.
Good thing.
Yeah. So this is one.
Before you continue.
Yes.
Reykjavik.
Yes, Abir.
Do these northern lights form automatically or some?
No, it's a switch inserted in the North Pole.
No, it's a natural phenomenon. So it's because of the disturbance in magnetosphere, one of the layer of the Earth's layer. And it's because of the solar wind. It forms the disturbance in the Earth's layer. And because of that, these lights are formed. Okay?
Reykjavik.
There is some chemical process also. There is some ionization. Protons and electrons are mixed around, and that's why these lights are reflected on the sky.
This is in Reykjavik, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
The place is one of the lowest crime rates in the entire world.
Yeah,
it's so low that that there's a law that turtles, it's illegal to own a turtle here.
Oh.
Then also there are almost like no criminals to lock up.
Yeah. As Rohita told us that Iceland is one of the safest countries in the world. So it's good to backpack and go over there and visit the country. So it's one, as you said, this is one of
not
the top.
In a pandemic time like this.
Huh? Yes, Abir?
But not in a pandemic time like this.
None of the countries are safe right now. So when everything is over and everything is open for visiting, that is one of the safest place. Okay. So this is one of the tallest and most recognizable building in the country. So the cuisines, there are many cuisines, mostly. Oh. Yes.
This does not look yummy.
Yeah. So there are seafood also because there is too many coastline over there.
Yummy.
Yes.
I love seafood, you know.
Yeah. So the cuisine of Iceland has a long history and mostly they eat lamb, dairy, fish and latter due to the fact Iceland has traditionally been inhabited only near the coastline. That is because they have a long coastline as I told you.
And,
and most of the popular food are called as kheer and hangikjor. Their pronunciation might be different because the way they pronounce and how they write, some words can be silent and some letters cannot be. So, there is that. So, these are the...
Wait.
Yes?
You first said seafood.
Uh-huh.
Why would people eat seafood if it's so cold? It's come from so cold water and it's non-vegetarian.
They don't serve it as soon as they fish it out of the water.
Yes, it will be warm, right, after taking out of the water. So in some countries, did you know that they use refrigerator for heating purpose, not for cooling purpose, especially in Alaska and all. So
what?
They use this also. Yes.
Refrigerators are cold. So
yes.
How can it become warm?
Because that is outside itself is so cold. They feel that refrigerator is more better than that. It's slightly warmer than the cold environment outside.
But that is quite cold then.
Yeah, but you don't know the climate of that region, right? So there might be that also. So
plus, Iceland.
It did plus something new.
Uh-huh.
Here, Iceland
plus it's non-vegetarian.
Yes, Abir?
I said plus it's non-vegetarian and you are just eating animals there.
Yeah, it depends on the people they have brought up like that. Their individual beliefs and culture also depends on that. So if the people don't want to eat it, they won't eat it. That's how it is.
Yeah, I mean, it's your choice. Feel free.
Yes, but it's one's own choice and we should all respect each other's choice. So with that, we are moving on to the airlines. That's Iceland Air, which is a flag carrier, which means
something will be like air.
Yes, yes, Arhan.
I knew in the airline something will be air.
Yes. So it's
I knew that.
It's a national airline.
And I'm sure it flies over all the ice.
Yes, it might look beautiful from up over the sky, right? And if it's night, I don't know if you can see aurora or not. I think it's only seen in the very wide area, vast areas. So,
and you'll be able to see the peaks much more clearly from the top. Like
and all the ice underneath and the water underneath. So it might be very beautiful to see. So with that, we come to an end. And do you want to see a video?
Yes, ma'am. Italy khatam ho gaya.
Ma'am.
All right.
Yeah, that's why it's...
It's absolutely beautiful, right?
But I'm not visiting there. Unless I know. I'm not visiting there unless someone tells me. Unless I hear about some
animals.
Some amazing animal. I can only go there for that. Otherwise, I'm not going.
Unfortunately, we have not included any animals over here because it's mostly famous for the places over there and the climate over there. That's why. So the next country we are visiting on Monday is Israel. Have you heard of
Israel?
That?
I thought that we are going to meet Israel.
Yeah.
Me too.
Okay. So, does anyone else have any facts to share or anything like that?
No.
All but right.
I had the number of places.
Yes, tell us.
I have one fact.
I found the black sand beach, geyser, thing relief,
yes,
and a landmann lauger.
I think all those places we have seen in the video itself, right?
Yeah.
The black sand sea and all those things.
So.
Yes.
Any fun fact about Iceland?
Yes, Ansh.
Any tasks?
Ma'am, the people of the Iceland, they not use the surnames. They use at the surname, they use the mother or father's name.
Oh, that's good to know. So with that, we have Israel on Monday. So I have a small task for you. I want you to draw a flag of Israel.
That's too easy.
And
I know the flag of Israel.
Okay, so you draw the flag of Israel and also the language of Israel. Okay, look up the language of Israel. And write three words if you can only, because the language is slightly difficult, I guess, to pronounce. I don't know for sure. So write three words in their language, okay? That is Hebrew. All right?
Hebrew.
Yes. So see you on Monday. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Have a
nice day.
Bye, bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Have a good day. Bye.
Bye, ma'am. Have a nice
day. What did you say about the...
What?
I said...